Today, we're going to be looking at how to install the Wraith Prism cooler.
This video is brought to you by my personal pocketbook, so if you'd like to help me out, like, subscribe, and check out my Patreon page so I can make more videos like this one.
The easiest way to install this cooler is just to get somebody who already knows how to do it for you. But if you want to learn, well, we can get to that. But the first thing you have to do is get a little zen, a little Ryzen, perhaps even channel Lisa Su's soothing voice. Because me, like many, have become frustrated with trying to mount this thing. And there's one particular trick having to do with this little guy here that makes it really easy. So once you know that, it's very, very simple. So what you're gonna need is obviously the cooler. You're gonna need an AM4 motherboard with the mounting hardware. Any AM4 motherboard will come with the hardware pre-mounted. You're also gonna need some new thermal paste. Although if you already have the stock thermal paste on the back there, that's totally fine. You don't need to replace it. However, if you do want to replace it or you just need some new thermal paste, there's a video you can check out of mine where I describe how to apply thermal paste. All right, so we're here. We got everything we need. We got our CPU cooler. I got my thermal paste. This is a Noctua NTH2 if you want it. I think I'm going to put a link there in the description. It's pretty good thermal paste. I have a video about that. But generally what you want to do, if you're a first timer especially, you want to kind of install this, not kind of, you want to install this outside of the case. So if your motherboard is outside of the case, it's going to make this much easier. In fact, it's going to make most of putting the things on the motherboard much easier, like the RAM, the CPU, and any kind of storage you have that's actually placed on the motherboard. So I would recommend doing that. I'm not going to do that for myself here because my motherboard's already in the case and I don't think it's worth it. But one thing you do need to watch out for here, and this is the real trick. So if you look here, you can see this little latch there. And at least to me, this has been a pitfall I've fallen into, and I've seen other people do it. When you go to put this on, make sure that it is in this position. You'll see that little point, fits into that small little groove. And then when it's closed, you can see it pull the lever and pull this metal piece up. And that's what's gonna create the tension. So make sure that little thing right there is right in that notch. All right, so it's pretty straightforward. All you're gonna have to do is make sure that you got your thermal paste on your CPU. So like I said, we have this Noctua NTH2. Don't need too much, just a little dab, that's plenty. Probably more than enough. I'm sure I'll have to clean that up later. It's close to the center, that's good. If it's a bit lower on the CPU, that's good as well, because the way that this kind of goes on, and it's gonna spread it upwards just a little bit. So that should be pretty good. So the first thing you wanna do, like I said, make sure that that is latched down that way. Keep this out of the way. And then you're gonna hook this piece here onto that little black notch. All right, just use caution, because this can be a little tricky without smearing the CPU paste on the motherboard. So there it is, it's hooked on, and if I pull up, it won't let me move it any further. Here's the tricky part. It's gonna be hard for you to see. I'm gonna have to basically lay on my computer for you to be able to see this. This is really awkward. But is all you have to do is put a little pressure with your finger underneath that latch so that it doesn't get stuck on the other side. So now that it's on top, all you have to do is just push down on that lever. So you hear that snap? Now it's latch on to that black bracket. And now all you have to do is make sure that the cooler is on there and flip that latch over to the locked position. And that is gonna put pressure. And you might notice that it takes quite a bit of pressure to turn that over, but now you can see it's in the locked position. And that CPU cooler is going to be nice and snug on there. Now, all you have to do at this point is plug in your CPU fan cable to your CPU fan header. There we go. And she's good to go. That's it. So I was going to do this video a certain way, but I decided to change it. So you might have noticed that on the bottom here, there's three different things. There's two grommets on this side. These little grommets that I've removed already, and those belong to these two cables. One of them is gonna be this USB cable. It just plugs into a USB header on your motherboard, and the other one is an RGB header, which will plug into, say, that RGB header there. So these do similar things. So this one I'm going to demonstrate because I'm going to plug it in and I'll show you on the software what it does. But this RGB header, essentially all it's going to do is sync up, I believe, just the fan color with whatever your motherboard RGB is doing. Now, on the other hand, this guy will let you actually install the software that's proprietary, and I believe it's made by Cooler Master or somebody. Anyways, it doesn't matter. It lets you control the fan and also the ring, and I think this also lights up. We'll have to take a look. And the last thing is that there's a little switch there. It says LH. All that does is let you change the maximum RPM of the fan. I believe the low is at 3000 RPM max, and the high is 3800 RPM max, which is quite fast, but considering it's a small fan, it kind of needs that speed to push the air. I just leave it on low. I think that's fine. Oh, and one more thing you want to do before you put everything back together is just make sure it turns on, and make sure that fan is turning. So make sure you have your power switched on, hit that power button, and she's spinning. Looks good. Okay, so we're booted up in Windows, and the first thing I want to do is actually check the CPU temps. So here I have HWinfo 64. So I have a video about this. If you'd like to know more about it, you can go check that out. But any software you want to use, that's totally fine. You can even use the proprietary software from AMD. I think it's called Ryzen Master, which will give you a CPU reading. I personally like to use HWinfo. So it's open here, and I'm going to scroll down to see my CPU readings. And I like to use the CPU die average one. Also, the CPU CC die 1 T die is also good to look at. So what do we got here? We're looking like we're in the mid-40s, averaging at 45-ish, which is a bit warm. But again, it is pretty warm in my room right now. It's like 26. Yeah, that's okay. That's not bad. It's not great, but it's not bad. What you want to be worried about more is when you're gaming. So my processor is a 3700X. So if you're using one of these, I've mentioned it in other videos, you're probably not necessarily going to be wanting to use it on a Ryzen 7 or Ryzen 9, which they come with. I mean, if you're buying one of those CPUs, you're probably going to be buying some kind of aftermarket cooler. Anyways, I've said this before, if you can get this thing secondhand for a Ryzen 3 or Ryzen 5, absolutely fantastic cooler. Anyways, so my thermals are fine. Again, like I said, not amazing, but totally fine in that range. So we'll close that out. And the next thing I want to do is download the utility app, the Wraith Prism LED control utility. You just have to go to the AMD website to find this. I'll put a link in the description below, but just download that for your Windows, whatever Windows you're using. For me, that's going to be 64-bit. So like I mentioned before, I didn't plug in the RGB cable into the header on my motherboard. I'm just using the USB header plug right now. So we can control the three different LEDs, the ring LED, the fan LED, and the logo LED. So right now, let's see, let's mess around with that. Let's turn the speed up on that guy. And that's going. That's going. Let me turn that down. Let's see what we got. Brightness down. Not a whole lot of control there. That's pretty cool though. I want to see what kind of colors I can. You can just straight up turn it off. Rainbow, Morse code, swirl. Oh yes, swirl. I like. All right, so this function here is pretty cool. This is new to me. They call it Mirage. And what it looks like it does, it doesn't show up on camera super well. You can definitely see it on camera. Actually, you can see it on camera. That is pretty neat. It gives this really strange, like the, it looks like the fan's almost moving more slowly. It's the frequency at which the LEDs are flashing, essentially. If you turn it down really low. Oh, that's wild. This in person looks much cooler than it does on camera, but that's definitely something to try out. That's fun. I like that. So obviously this cooler has quite a lot of RGB functions. I'm actually quite impressed with the customization you can do in here. I didn't realize it was this extensive. It makes me almost want to just use it just to have fun with the RGB. It's kind of mesmerizing, isn't it? It's kind of like looking at a fire. That is kind of nice. Maybe I'll use this for the next little while. I don't think I'm going to go anything crazy with my overclocking or anything, so I think I could use this cooler. All right, guys, that was the tutorial. I hope it was helpful. If you want any other specific tutorials, please let me know in the comments below. I did shout out to other tutorials that I have done. I obviously have quite the mess to clean up. Holy crap, I can't believe how much of a mess I made in this room today. It's a little a little ridiculous. But anyways, thanks again, guys. My name is Nick Laporte. This is Tech Illiterate. Thanks for watching.